Recently, EPFL School of Life Sciences has gotten a new dean. His name is Professor Andy Oates, and today we caught up with him to ask him a few questions. Hi, Andy. Thanks for joining us today.
Hi. You're welcome.
So I guess the first question we have is, how has it been? 6 months as a dean, how are you finding it?
Well, it's interesting. It's definitely interesting. There's so many new people, new processes, new science to learn all the time. I mean, it feels like I'm going back to the beginning again. That's great. So it's exciting too. A lot of the things that you have to think about are pressing, so, or they're going to have a big consequence. So that, you know, it is really exciting stuff. And I guess by the end of the day, it's actually often quite exhausting. I get home and I want to put my feet up.
Well, aside from the positives, there must have been some negatives too and some challenges.
Well, the biggest challenge was definitely the COVID pandemic. Yeah. And that has affected all operations of the school. We've been under restrictions from the lectures to how we operate the experiments to just everything really. And we've got people from all around the world who haven't seen their families for a year. And so it's been a tough time. But I think for me, the amazing thing is the work that the decanar did last year in getting these organization in place and things like that, that's made it a lot easier for me to come on. But it's been a tough time, I can say.
So where do you see the School of Life Sciences on the global map of life science itself? How do you see it?
I think EPFL is in a really unique position because it's a relatively young school placed down in the middle of a polytechnic campus. And this gives us an enormous number of opportunities that a traditional biology department just wouldn't have. So I see the excitement and the opportunities there as being able to take advantage of interactions with the technical school that we're in.
The final question, what's your vision for the life sciences at EPFL?
Well, that is a good question. So I think that has three components to it. One is to take advantage of the immense power of computational approaches now to both to push our own science forward and to advance health, well-being and medical applications. I think that's going to dominate the next 100 years of life sciences. Second thing is to take advantage of the materials engineering that's going on. And I think what's amazing at the moment is the ability to take stem cells from patients or other samples and get them to self-organize into tissues from which we can learn all sorts of things. I think there's going to be a real opportunity there to reduce the number of animals that enter into experimentation. I think that's really important. And I think the final thing is to get life sciences to think about its role in sustainability. And that has a number of different facets, from how we run the labs in life sciences to how we direct our research towards these goals that are truly global. And there the students come in, because the students are now saying to us, we need to know how to save the planet and you need to do your best to teach us. And you know, that puts us, that makes us put our thinking caps on. And that's a real challenge. So I think that's how I'm seeing the future. I think that's where we've got to go.
Well, Andy, thank you for being with us today and thank you for taking our questions. And we'll all be looking forward to seeing what you bring to the School of Life Sciences as its dean.
Well, you are very welcome, but it won't be just me. It'll be all of us.
Well, thank you very much.
Cheers.